One area of southern Maine hit especially hard by Tropical Storm Irene was a small stretch of homes along the north shore of Sebago Lake. While the storm knocked down dozens of trees and sent boats crashing against the rocks, the residents there are dealing with another problem, just getting out. News 8's Steve Minich has more in our continuing coverage tonight.
Good end makes me a little nervous.
After riding out Tropical Storm Irene at their vacation house, Jennifer Harris and her family were hoping to head home to Massachusetts today. But with downed trees and power lines blocking any access to the neighborhood, they're stuck. Still, Jennifer says that is not her biggest concern.
It's not so much being without power as it is that we're stuck and nobody could get in. If there was an emergency, someone in here had a heart attack or using one of their chainsaws got hurt, there's no way to get an ambulance in here.
Yesterday's storm pounded Sebago's north shore. The winds and waves too much for these small boats, which broke loose, crashing against the rocks. This morning, the damage already done, neighbors who saw it happen said they were helpless.
There was 6 to 8 foot waves smashing in here, so yeah, not much you could do.
Up the road, others were dealing with a different type of damage. Dozens of fallen trees, many ending up on houses. Several neighbors, lucky enough to escape any damage to their own homes, went to work lending a hand.
They're helping each other out all the time. If you got a boat, you're always helping somebody else out on a lake, so this is just a bigger thing.
While the people here on the North Shore say they are used to ferocious winds whipping across the open lake, they have never seen any damage like this.
I was more excited to watch the waves. It was a little scary, though.
Did you hear the trees come down?
You could hear that crack.
Ask anyone here, though, and they're just happy nobody even came close to getting hurt. In North Sebago Shores, Steve Minich, News 8.